ท่านผู้ชมครับผมเดินทางมาที่ Bangkok Golf Center นะครับเพราะว่าสถานที่แห่งนี้มีการปรับปรุงใหม่ครับแล้วก็มีการนำอุปกรณ์ใหม่ๆแล้วก็เทคโนโลยีใหม่ๆเข้ามาช่วยในการทำฟิตติ้งให้ดีขึ้นครับผมเลยมาคุยกับ Founder นะครับก็คือคุณเอริกนั่นเองครับเป็น Founder ที่ทำ Mice Band Big Fish ครับ Hey Eric how are you
Hi good morning
Good morning Know you for a long time never been on TV with you before
Well it's a great honor to be on TV with you
Yep
and to talk about club fittingas a whole.
Sure. I know this place, we've been here before, but this place has developed a lot and you come to, you know, be the fitter here. So first of all, let's tell me about your experience about club fitting.
Well, I've been doing club fitting for the last 9 years. I've probably seen thousands and thousands of swings of both average golfers and elite golfers, professional golfers. So it's been a long journey and it's been a great learning experience for me as well.And to share this with you on TV, I think it's a great honor.
Okay, perfect. So, what's new here in the Bangkok Golf Center that you come and put it together?
Well, I think Bangkok Golf Center is a great facility, number one. It's a great facility for golfers to train themselves, to get better at what they want to do in golf. And if you look at the integration between becoming a better golfer than you are, you need to have the right physical training, you need to have the right technique, and you definitely need to have the right clubs.
Sure.
So that you have better confidence over your game.
Okay.
So that's what we are bringing to Bangkok Golf Center, to impart better confidence to the golfers, so that they know there's no more question mark about their golf clubs.
Okay.
So they need to focus on their training, they need to focus on their movement,and they need to focus on their game.
Okay, so three things that you bring up to here. So first one is the physical thing and club fitting. And the third one is...
Understanding how you integrate the movement.
Okay.
So that we can build a better club for the golfer.
Okay, so how about we specifically to... Because our show is about the club fitting. How about what's new for fitting the club here? If the golfer come here,And they said to you, hey, I want to fit the club. What are you going to do with that?
Okay, if I were to share the process of fitting, number one, we have to look at the aspiration of the golfers.
Okay.
Because not every golfer is going to be a club champion, or not every golfer that you see wants to be a great golfer. Some of them just want to play golf with their friends. Some of them want to enjoy the walk. Some of them want to get better, and some of them really wants to be a very good league player, for example. So we have to understand their aspirations. And once we understand their aspirations, we would know what is it that they would be open to and what are the changes that they are open to so that we can give them the right guidance. So not everybody is the same. Everybody is different.
Okay.
Right? So by understanding what is their need is the first step of what we need to do.
Okay.
And then after we've understand their need.
So we have to look at the particular golfer. What do they want for that, right?
Right. So the aspiration could be breaking 100, breaking 90, breaking 80, and breaking 70.
Yeah.
So it all depends on how much effort they are willing to put in, so that we can build a set of clubs that will actually match that aspiration. So a lot of times when fitters look at a golfer, they forgot to see how the golfer would be, how the golfer will evolve.In 3 months' time, in 6 months' time, in 12 months' time. And they also fail to understand that every golfer would basically have a training routine.
Yeah.
Are they willing to train? Are they going to be trained? Can they handle the weight for 4 days of competitive golf? So such are the questions that we, as a fitter, we have to explore and discover so that we can share this information with the golfer and explain to them why we are fitting them a club that plays in a particular way.
Okay. And then after you know that goal, you know there how much effort they want to put in, what's next? You look at the swing first or you look at the club first?
Basically, the most important thing when we look at the fitting of a player is basically movement. That movement that can be repeated successfully over 2 days, 3 days, 4 days of golf. Now that movement is a big question mark because how do I judge movement?
Okay.
How do the golfer be convinced that this is the right club that will suit his movement?
Yeah.
And that's why we use technology.
Okay.
And I think if you look at technology today, we have technology like launch monitor.
Yep.
We have technology like K-Vest that allows you to see a golfer's movement, whether he's in the right sequence, right? Thorax, hands, pelvis, which is right. So we also have PGA standards that we look at and we compare.
Sure.
Is the golfer making the right movement?
Mm-hmm.
Now, having that, the last one we have would be a body track. Body track is basically looking at weight transfer. And today, if you look at the modern game is all about repeatability, ease, and compactness. So you don't have a lot of big movement, but you have small movement that actually create efficiency and repeatability. And this is what we look for. So when we look at fitting a club, for example, we always have to look at weight, flex, and also the profile of the different shafts that we use. So although golfers would like to use clubs that they associate with their idols, if we can convince them that this is what they should be playing. For example, if they are hitting down most of the time, they need a more lofted club. Maybe even 10 and a half or 11 degree. Or if they are hitting up, they can actually go into like 8 and a half or even lower. So that information from technology will actually help us convince the golfer.
Okay.
Because it's what the eyes cannot see.
Yeah.
It's what video cannot see.
Yeah.
So this is where technology helps us establish those parameters.
Yeah, that's very interesting. We're gonna try it next for the next break. We're gonna use the FlyScope, look at the number as a launch monitor, and we're gonna have the what is it, the weight
body track.
Body track
and then we're gonna have K-Vest.
Alright, we're gonna see that. Okay, perfect. So for our next break, we're going to see Atik. But right now, thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Proit. Thank you very much.
All right.
It's a big pleasure.